All right. Well, then, come on now. DeMar DeRozan came back after going through COVID protocols. DeRozan scored 38 points for the second time against the Lakers this season. He's been huge for this team all season long. And speaking of DeRozan, look at the impact that he's had on the Bulls this season. When he's on the court, the team's defensive efficiency would be the second best in the NBA. And then on the offensive, defensive efficiency.
Impressive.
And then, Ramona, let's go over to the offensive end. And their efficiency is nearly 9 points better when he is playing. So now joining us is our senior writer for the undefeated, Marc Spears. Marc, we've been talking about DeMar DeRozan, the impact he's had. How important has this free agency acquisition been for the Bulls?
Well, it's not only important for the Bulls, but it's important for him. You know, he was playing in Canada, although he was great in Canada. Us Americans tend not to pay attention enough, right? Then he's in San Antonio, kind of out of the spotlight there. But this is the biggest spotlight he's had in his career. Being in Chicago, and right now, he's fourth in the NBA in scoring, 26 points a game. It's also big for the Bulls because now they have a superstar trio with him and LaVine, who's hopefully will be back soon, and Vucevic, who we don't give enough credit to. This is a great, great three-man star rotation. And he told me about a month ago, he's like, one thing he loves about the Bulls is nobody is selfish. Everyone wants to go out there and have fun. And also shout out to Mark Eversley, who worked with him in Toronto and went to L.A., talked to DeRozan face-to-face and convinced him to come to Chicago.
Well, and then we saw Zach LaVine fire off a tweet literally as the game was ending, complimenting DeMar DeRozan. And then, you know, a little typo, but that's okay, Zach. We all make them. So, like you said, hopefully Zach LaVine is back soon. I do want to then go over to Detroit because rookie Cade Cunningham, he had 10 assists. That's not easy in a win over the Heat yesterday. So is he starting to put his name in the Rookie of the Year race after missing a little bit of time early this season?
I need the folks out there to pay attention to this diary I'm doing with Cade. He's talking a little trash and backing it up. About a month ago, he said, yeah, y'all thought I was a bust. And I thought that was pretty funny. Remember that slow start he had after having an ankle injury? Well, he's been killing it in December. He's averaging 19 points, 5 rebounds, 6 assists, and nearly 2 steals. And he's also shooting 42% from 3-point range. Jeremy Grant is gone for going to be out a while with a thumb injury. And dare I say, now he's starting to move into the Rookie of the Year conversation. I know there's a guy in Toronto and Cleveland would probably want to say otherwise right now. But, hey, Cade Cunningham is living up to the billing. He's been a superstar of late, especially in December with the Pistons.
Well, it'll be fun to continue to watch his game mature. And absolutely, you mentioned your diaries. I will be tuning into those on The Undefeated. Thank you so much for joining us, Marc. I do want to go back to one of the first things that Marc said. I'm rejoined now by Ramona and Chinee. I want to talk more about DeMar DeRozan. What has his impact been, Ramona, on this Bulls team?
I mean, he's that veteran leader, that veteran scorer, but he comes up big in the fourth quarter. He had 19 points in the fourth quarter yesterday. He's averaging 8.5 points in the fourth quarter. That's the most of any player in the NBA this year. And when you have a guy who's a veteran player like that who can deliver in the clutch, that's huge for a young team that's trying to learn how to win.
Absolutely. How annoying. You stole my nugget, my note. I guess we're supposed to share homework if we both come from Stanford. I absolutely agree. The fourth quarter is where he's feeling his most confident self. And I think, you know, early in the year, before they had their issues with COVID and players weren't available, he was right there in the mix for MVP discussion. What I will bring up is I think at some point when you're a player, you realize, all right, I'm great. I'm good at this. Like, the mid-range was my bag.
Yep.
But you have to bring different facets of the game that can sort of galvanize your team. In Toronto, we saw his strengths, but now we're seeing his impact on a team overall for the Chicago Bulls. And I think that subtle change in his mindset defensively, like, I'm going to go with the guy like Caruso and making sure we have a rim protect. Like, that subtle change as a veteran has really changed the outlook of his career.
Well, and when you think back to the offseason when the Bulls acquired DeMar DeRozan, the chatter that was surrounding that acquisition was, is this the worst possible acquisition of the offseason? Does this fit make any sense at all? Remember that, though, right? That was the conversations that was being had. And now, I mean, it is, you mentioned MVP. Is DeRozan hovering in the top five MVP?
I think adjacent, but like right up in the mix.
Top five adjacent.
Top 10.
Top 10?
Yeah. Like, top,
there's a 10.
The problem is that he's been unavailable.
He doesn't go that deep.
He's been unavailable, but now he's back, and he can make the case himself. And I think you're absolutely right when it comes to the free agency discussions that we had, because Ramona, correct me, what was it, 38-6, right, against the Lakers that you mentioned in those two games against them? I mean, wasn't he sort of vying, Ramona, correct me if I'm wrong, to try to be on the Lakers in the free agency summer?
I mean, there was a time over the summer when everyone in L.A. thought DeMar was going to be a Laker. Mm. They were going to find a way to do it. Now, the mechanics of it and the financials of it, there's some dispute over it. I don't think he was ever going to take that mid-level exception that people thought he would come for. He ended up getting $85 million from the Bulls.
And is playing for every penny of that $85 million.
But then, like, when you're an L.A. guy, and this is a dream of yours, and you don't get that, and people have concerns about your career, is he a right fit for X, Y, or Z team, that's what's motivated him to play so well in Chicago. And so sometimes it's not the team that you want to go to. It's a team that wants you and needs you. You hear that a lot of times when it comes to young players in the draft, like, oh, I wanted to go here, I want to go there. Like, the reality is the team that needs you and wants you, that's the best position for you, and that seems to be Chicago.
Well, and Zach LaVine was on the show the first week of NBA Today saying how confident he was in his roster. And I think at that time there were still some folks saying, you sure? Really? What about the fit? There seems to be some redundancy on this roster. And now when you see the way that Lonzo Ball, when you see the way that Zach LaVine, when you see the way that DeMar DeRozan and Alex Caruso, you go down the list, have been gelling and playing together, especially with the woes that they had, it's pretty impressive. Yeah.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.